Everybody, welcome back to Chipstock Investor. We're going to be talking about one of our Fab 5 companies today, Lam Research. We'll be talking about these three key points. We'll discuss the December 2024 quarter and the 2025 outlook that Lam Research gave us. And then we'll discuss how some of the companies in the Fab 5 are leaving their home turf. What does that mean exactly? We'll discuss it. And we'll do an updated reverse discounted cash flow for Lam Research and talk about what we're doing for our portfolio personally.
Just a brief refresh before we get into the latest quarter from Lam Research. Lam, part of the Fab 5, which includes ASML, Applied Materials, of course, Lam Research, Tokyo Electron, and KLA Corp, all participate in the wafer fab packaging and assembly equipment providers. Collectively, we call them the Fab Five because they control about 70% of the revenue in this subsegment of the semiconductor industry supply chain and industry flow.
Here's a chart from semi.org on the expected ramp up of semi-fab equipment sales this year and into 2026. You can see that represented in the blue bar in this chart. Semi.org doesn't expect a huge growth in fab equipment this year, but it does expect acceleration in 2026. This expectation really goes along with the U-shaped recovery that we've been discussing in other parts of the semiconductor supply chain as well. Basically, the first half of 2025 will be a bit lackluster for industry sales overall, but it will start to heat up in the second half of the year.
And Lam Research's management just doused a little bit of cold water on that expectation, especially for the first half of calendar year 2025. They updated their expectations for total wafer fab equipment spending for this year and said they expect it to be maybe about $100 to $105 billion this year. So maybe a couple billion less than what semi.org's previous outlook was. Part of this is you can blame new U.S. restrictions on equipment sales to China. And Lam got hit with this as well. Within their CSBG or customer service business group, which we'll be discussing in a bit more detail here momentarily, they report some old legacy tool sales to Chinese chip fabs. Now, previously, most of the export controls had been on leading edge equipment to try to hobble China's expansion and ability to create their own AI chips. But now some of those restrictions also extending to older equipment as well. Things are getting weird out there with this, but this is the reality of things right now. Lam getting hit a bit by those new export controls. We'll keep you up to date if we see anything worth calling out going forward.
Before we continue, quick word from the sponsor of today's video, public.com. If you're serious about investing, you need to know about public.com. That's where you can invest in everything. Stocks, options, bonds, crypto. They even offer some of the highest yields in the industry, like the new bond account 6% or higher yield that remains locked in even if the Fed cuts rates.
Will the Fed actually cut rates in 2025? That remains to be seen. Let's see what happens there. But public.com, what sets itself apart from a lot of other online brokers is they really do a great job providing you a one-stop shop with all the tools you need to make an informed investment decision. Included in that tool set, a built-in AI tool called Alpha doesn't just tell you if an asset is moving, but really gets to the heart of the matter and tells you the why is the asset price moving in the direction that it is.
Public is FINRA registered, SIPC insured, US-based company with a customer support team that actually cares. Bottom line, your investments deserve a platform that takes them as seriously as you do. Fund your account in 5 minutes or less at public.com/CSI and get up to $10,000 when you transfer your old portfolio.
That's public.com/CSI. This ad is paid for by Public Investing. Full disclosures in the podcast and video description below.
Okay, back to our episode. Lam has been busy rebuilding its sales on a sequential basis for almost 2 years now. Based on the midpoint of guidance for Q1, we can expect another modest 6% quarter-over-quarter increase in revenue. You can see that highlighted in the yellow bars on our chart here. And then operating margin, which is in orange, we'll both on a GAAP basis and an adjusted basis, should also increase a bit sequentially from that long-term cost optimization initiatives that management has put in place.
Yeah, this is modest, but more than respectable, and is the reason why we chose Lam as, I guess we could say, our new long-term bet on the memory chip market. So we've discussed that multiple times in past videos in 2024. We'll link those for you if you're interested in learning more about that. But we'll come back to this late in the video when we do our reverse DCF. We're expecting something like a mid-teens or high teens percentage growth rate in earnings per share for 2025, driven by that steady increase in revenue and profit margin stabilization, or a bit of profit margin expansion as 2025 progresses. Now, Kasey, let's talk about this CSBG, or we have it highlighted in pink, customer support related revenue.
Lam is going to see some headwinds in this segment because of that loss of customers in China. But Lam does have some unique things happening in the customer service segment. Before we talk more about Lam, let's look at, for comparison's sake, Applied Materials, Applied Global Services, or AGS segment. Lam's service segment is 40% of revenue last quarter to about 23% for Applied Materials.
And a lot going on in CSBG. Again, last year we talked about one of the services they provide is helping their customers move existing equipment around the fab and repurpose it for a different manufacturing line. For example, let's say your Micron or SK Hynix, Kasey, put together some great research on SK Hynix last week. If you haven't caught that video, check it out. We also did Micron back in December, of course, after their latest earnings. But both of those companies have been talking about moving some of their old equipment that is used in DRAM and moving it to high bandwidth memory production, HBM, for accelerators and AI chips. Lam is going to sell some new equipment for HBM, but a lot of existing equipment can be repurposed for that HBM, and Lam still earns some revenue by helping those customers move that equipment around to those new manufacturing lines and stuff. But this time around, let's talk about two new innovations. Kasey mentioned point number two, some of the Fab Five, in this case, we'll talk about Lam, breaking out of their home turf, wafer fab equipment, into new areas. And there's two things that are bundled up in CSBG at Lam that we think are worth calling out.
We'll talk about Semiverse Solutions and that little robotic arm that you see in under CSBG. Let's first focus on Semiverse Software Solutions. This may call to mind NVIDIA's Omniverse, which creates 3D graphics and digital twin simulation software used to build things virtually before building them in real life. Lam's two products, the Simulator 3D and Overviz, may have used NVIDIA's Omniverse to produce these software applications. On the left, Simulator 3D, this was designed to help early on in the development process for a new semiconductor manufacturing process. As the technology and manufacturing of semiconductors gets more complex and expensive, this tool can help create a virtual design of what the microscopic 3D structures on a silicon wafer would look like after running them through a new manufacturing process. Obviously, a very important tool that could help with efficiency and cost.
Yeah, absolutely. Related to this, Overviz, this is a plasma physics simulation software suite. So plasma, the fourth state of matter, used in various steps of the wafer manufacturing process, everything from deposition to certain types of dry etching, ion implantation. So Overviz helps with solving some of the complex physics problems that are involved with using plasma in the manufacturing process. So this might remind you a little bit of Synopsys's pending acquisition of Ansys, or Cadence Design making some similar acquisitions in the last year. EDA software providers getting into the physics simulation game. This is a hot part of the manufacturing industry right now. Being able to simulate something before you actually manufacture it has massive potential to save you in operating costs. So Lam Research very much wanting to get in on this game. It has the equipment, to be able to do it. So why not just add in this layer of software?
The other big innovation happening at Lam Research, we can focus on that little robotic arm. There's so many challenges to getting talent in to operate these manufacturing facilities, talent that is possibly not readily available to recruit. That's a challenge that Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing is having in Arizona, for example. That's why Lam has introduced this little robotic arm, or a cobot, named Dextro.
You can see Dextro performing various functions in a chip fab, not supposed to replace the humans, but maybe more like helping the humans get more done in the same amount of time. We're not sure that we're there yet for humanoid robots being able to walk around a chip fab and not be supervised. So, you know, that's maybe good news if you're worried about robots taking over and becoming our overlords. But the point here, Lam is probably sourcing these robotic arms, training them to perform these specialized functions within the fab, maybe developing the assembly at the end of the arm that actually performs the task. And this puts Lam Research in competition with a lot of different robotics companies out there. For example, one that came to my mind was Teradyne, another company that participates in the wafer fab equipment on the testing side of the equipment. But they have two robotics segments as well. Teradyne acquired Universal Robots and MER a number of years ago. Universal Robots in particular being the division that makes things like robotic arms. Maybe there's a partnership here going on between Lam and Teradyne. Maybe Lam is getting the robotic arms from somewhere else. We don't know. We have some folks over on Semi Insider that had pointed this out and brought this to our attention, that perhaps Lam is sourcing these from someone. So if you want to hang out with a great community of long-term minded business owners, check out Semi Insider. Link to that right here in the video.
The point of all this is to say that Lam is not a one-trick pony. They're breaking out of their equipment roots and moving into other directions, including end-market tech equipment and devices. So be it enterprise software, robotics, or something else, Lam has optionality built in with a very solid balance sheet and more net cash flowing in every quarter. In fact, management said that it's going to be paying off the $500 million in debt that matures this year with some of that cash.
Yeah, they're free cash flow positive, have remained free cash flow positive throughout the bear market, and now coming out of the bear market, entering a new phase of growth. Lam is doing quite okay on that department. Optionality, a big deal here for these companies.
Okay, time to talk about our final point. Let's do an updated reverse DCF on Lam Research.
On the surface, if you're just looking at trailing 12-month price to earnings or trailing 12-month price to free cash flow, you may see Lam Research and think there's no great value here. In fact, you could possibly still at this point make a decent argument that this stock is a bit on the high end, maybe even entering premium territory, even after a pretty sizable sell-off last second half of last year, as reality settled in that memory chips weren't going to just somehow infinitely scale along with the AI industry. But let's go a little bit deeper here. We're going to do a reverse DCF, emphasis on reverse. This is not a straight line DCF based on our estimates. Remember, a reverse DCF is one scenario that we've landed on that we think the market has baked into expectations right now that makes Lam Research stock a good value today. So remember, not our expectations, one scenario of expectations that Wall Street has baked into the stock price today to make it fair value.
Actually, Nick, not much has changed since our October reverse DCF estimate, but here's our updated numbers. Trailing 12 months earnings per share of $3.29. That's using December's GAAP earnings per share on a stock split adjusted basis. For earnings per share growth rate, we put 20% in for 2 years. That's about the growth rate that we can expect from management. Terminal growth rate of 4.5%, discount rate of 10% gets us to around $82 per share for the fair value. Now, do we think this is reasonable?
For us personally, we think it is. And Remember at the beginning of this video, we showed you that semi.org outlook where we have that U-shaped recovery in 2025, growth being a bit muted, at least through the first half of this calendar year before maybe heating up a bit the second half of the year. And then expectations for a very widespread new record sales for companies like Lam in 2026. Remember, there's new fabs being built all over the world right now. And eventually, when the buildings are finished and the companies have the orders from customers to warrant doing the next step, they're going to buy new equipment from Lam and fill up those fabs and start cranking out new chips. So that's where the heat up in revenue is expected in 2026 from a lot of new fabs and fab updates taking place over the course of the next 2 years. And that's where we are pulling this earnings per share growth rate of 20%. Now, the terminal rate of 4.5%, to us, that seems low, but reasonable, because at some point, Lam is a cyclical business. There is going to be a cyclical downturn for their sales after this current phase of growth peters out. We think 4.5% is fairly conservative, but it does bake in an expected downturn maybe in 3 years out from now, maybe sooner, maybe later. Too soon to tell, obviously. We're a long ways away from 2027. So that's where these numbers came from to arrive at that fair value. For us, we think that is a reasonable expectation for Lam Research. And so we still like this stock. We're happy to continue holding this one and glad that we made an exception with this one when purchasing Fab 5 stocks in 2024. But we are warming up to the Fab 5 again in 2025.
If you want to get more up-to-date information on what we're adding to our portfolio, and more importantly, the why, check out Semiconductor Insider, link in the video description below. Get you access to our Discord server with a great community, as well as all of our show notes and research over there. See you all again soon at Chipstock Investor.